What's up, everybody? BTB, I am your host for the Lynx Lounge, and I just want to welcome you on our last arcade port episode. That's right. Believe it or not, we have covered 26 arcade ports for the Atari Lynx. It's pretty darn cool. Now, there are a few games that I haven't gone over, and that's going to be a completely different section because those are games that actually were released after Atari stopped producing games for the Lynx. So that's a whole nother section. Now, in this episode, I'm going to cover three games, and in good faith, I really can't add them to the arcade section because they're really not arcade ports. It's something completely different, and that's Turbo Sub, Gauntlet, and Super Asteroids and Super Missile Command. I'm going to call this section the Arcade Oddities, so let's hit it right now with Turbo Sub. Turbo Sub is an interesting game. It actually plays really well, and it's fun to play on the Lynx. Believe it or not, this is actually an arcade game, and if you played Turbo Sub, consider yourself very lucky because it is a very, very rare arcade cabinet. That's right, there were only about 15 to 20 cabinets built, and I really can't say that, you know, this is an arcade port because who the heck has ever played it? I've never played it. There is an amazing website called turbosub.com. And it talks about this company called Entertainment Science, and they created these two games that were super rare. They never really came out to the masses, and they're seen like in movies, like I think it was Ninja 3 or something like that. You could see it in the background. And then they made this other game called Turbo Sub. They actually used the arcade yoke for Star Wars and old arcade Star Wars cabinets in order to turn it into like a submarine theme. Very cool website, check it out. So how does it play on the Lynx, though? Well, it plays great. It's actually a pretty fun game. You fly your sub around, and you shoot UFOs, and then when it tells you to dive underwater, you go underwater, and then you shoot, like, mutated crabs, and you can collect power-ups and stuff like that. It's a good game. It's a fun ride. Is it an arcade port? I guess. I don't know. I've never really played the arcade, but you know, I'm sure it's pretty close. Music is good. Sound effects are good. All in all, it's a solid title. Is it an arcade port? I'm going to say kind of, sort of, I guess it is. I don't know. All right, moving along to a very, very strange port of a classic arcade game, Gauntlet. Or is it? Gauntlet the Third Encounter. Well, it starts off and it kind of looks like Gauntlet. I mean, I'm looking at it and I'm thinking, yeah, I'm going to play some Gauntlet here. However, let's take a look at the starting lineup. Well, the Wizard's there. That's good. And then I've got an Android. Okay, and a punk rocker. I got a pirate. You know what? There's a gunfighter. Hey, the Valkyrie's there. Look, the Valkyrie. Oh, so I have the Wizard and the Valkyrie. And I've got a nerd. Interesting, the nerd. Is that the nerd from Chip's Challenge? What's going on here? And there's a samurai. All right, well, listen, I'm going to pick the Wizard. I'm picking the Wizard because it's the closest thing to Gauntlet that we've got. So is this Gauntlet? Well, no, not really. In fact, it's called Time Quest and Treasure Chest. Wow, say that three times fast. I don't want to. Yeah, it was an Epics game, and I'm guessing that the people at Atari, the good folks at Atari, saw it and said, hey, that looks a lot like Gauntlet. You know what? We would probably sell more games if we slapped on the heroes for Gauntlet, called it Gauntlet, and not called it Time Quests and Treasure Chests. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna have a seizure just trying to pronounce that game. Good call on the Gauntlet, however, could you have given me Gauntlet? Now, looking at it, it does kind of look like Gauntlet. It plays a lot like Gauntlet. You've got an overhead map. Oh, but wait. If you're trying to play it like this, you're not going to be able to play it. You got to tilt it up like this, and you play it thusly. Cool thing about this game is that you could plug in four links together, and you could play four players. I mean, I guess that's why they have all the strange people to choose from, but why couldn't they have just given us the elf, the wizard, the warrior, and the Valkyrie? That's what we wanted. So, in good faith, I really can't say that this is an arcade port. It's something completely different, and it's Gauntlet slapped on the cover. Kind of cheap. I really wish we had a Gauntlet. Well, in 1995, Atari Corporation basically called it quits with the Atari Lynx, and they put out one last title, Super Asteroids and Missile Command, and what a way to go out. I mean, it's a pretty darn good game. It's Asteroids, it's Missile Command. It's their pillar titles that made Atari who they were. I mean, basically, these games were historical. So they went out with a bang, and they put some steroids in their flagship games. And you know what? It's a dang good game. Let's take a look at Super Asteroids. I mean, what is not to love about Asteroids? You're in a spaceship and you're blowing up space rocks. You get some really great power-ups, you know, power-ups like we never had before. And this is really sort of the juice that was needed to make this game interesting. Now, if you play Asteroids on the 7800, I mean, they kind of, you know, upped the ante on that one as well. They gave you co-op, which is super cool. They made the graphics look a little bit better. And, you know, they took that old title and kind of gave it some juice. Well, they did the same thing with the Lynx, and they made it super, super duper. The graphics are very detailed, you know, for Asteroids and Missile Command. It moves good, it plays good, it sounds good. The explosions are awesome, and there's a lot of really new gameplay elements that make it interesting. What about Missile Command? Is Missile Command any good? You bet Missile Command is good. Ask Mr. Awesome what he thinks about Missile Command, and he will tell you it's a good game. I don't know, I didn't talk to him. I don't know him personally, but I'm sure he likes it. It's Missile Command. This is a manly game, what can I say? You're blowing stuff up. There's missiles. You got your power-ups. And basically, you are just trying to survive the onslaught of whoever it is that's shooting those missiles at you. You know, back in the 80s, we all knew those missiles were coming from Russia. But I'm not too sure now. Where are these missiles coming from? Anyway, you've got an arsenal to keep people safe, and this is a great game. Very, very fun. There's four waves, and after the fourth wave, you are presented with a list of power-ups. So you get to choose, you know, fast missiles, double explosions, stuff like that. Obviously, like a good arcade game, it's going to start off slow, it's going to ramp up, and then you better buckle up because things are going to get crazy. So that wraps up the arcade oddities section, and it actually wraps up our entire arcade block on the Lynx Lounge. 26 titles we've covered. That's a lot. Now I could get into some really, really cool, unique, and different Lynx games that you've probably never heard of or never played, and now I get to showcase all of those. I can't wait to show those off because if you thought the arcade ports were cool, wait till you see some of the stuff that they do that is just way out of the box. Hey, if you like this presentation of Lynx Lounge, check out my other shows, 7800 Avenue and the Jag Bar. We cover a ton of Atari cool stuff, cool games. And if you want more, if you want that deep dive information, go to atari.io, and they have got all of the retro video game stuff that you need. You know, if you want to just find out any kind of information on something, boom, you go there. They've got forums, they've got chat rooms, high score challenges, all that cool stuff. It's there at atari.io. I hope you enjoyed all of the arcade ports that we covered here on the Lynx Lounge. I hope to see you again real soon on the next episode of the Lynx Lounge. Cheers.
Check out Atari.io for the very best in retro life and classic gaming. From Atari to Nintendo, Sega, TurboGrafx, and beyond. Atari.io.